Good morning, children. I am Radhika. Hope you are all doing well at home and safe. The current situation of COVID has brought every one of us in front of the gadgets. Let us use these gadgets to learn in a better way. Already we have completed in the online classes first three lessons. Now let us go on with the fourth lesson. So today I am going to take up a poem. The name of the poem is Chiri, which is written by Michael Rosen. Michael Rosen is an English children's poet. He has written around 140 books. He is an English children's poet. He has written around 140 books. He is a novelist also. Won many honors and awards into his credit. Now, let us read before going to the poem, children. Let us know what Chiri means. So, Chiri means to nag at something. You find someone saying repeatedly, do this, don't do this, sit like this. So, they go on giving you the instructions. Now these days, children, the present moment, when you switch on the TV, you come across a person saying, wash your hands for 20 seconds, don't go outside, have maintained social distance. So all these are being said in the TV continuously, repeatedly they'll say. So when it is said repeatedly, sometimes we get irritated or we find sometimes why it is being said continuously. So, did you ever thought why they are saying it continuously? Just to follow, not to be in trouble. So, here the poet Michael Rosen, Rosen was very small children at the age of 5 years. His mother has taken him to a nearby school for an admission. So, when he went there, when he sat in front of the teacher asked him, immediately, what is your name? Then Michael, without hesitating, very confidently, he said, Michael, don't. Have you understood, children? He said, Michael, don't. So, why do you think he might have said, Michael, don't? Because mother always repeatedly says, Michael, don't do this. Michael, don't do it. Michael, don't open the door. Michael, don't do this. So, often she says, Michael, not to do the things. So, it has been printed in his mind that Michael, don't. So, he might have thought that his name is, as he was just 5 years old, he might have thought that his name is Michael, don't. Okay, now let us read the poem. So, before reading the poem, children, every poem has rhyming scheme and also poetic devices. But here, this poem which has been written by Michael Rosen, it is a free verse and we don't have any poetic verse. Now let us read the poem Chiri, written by Michael Rosen. Grown-ups say things like, speak up, don't talk with your mouth full, don't stare, don't point, don't pick your nose, sit up, say please, less noise, shut the door behind you, don't drag your feet, haven't you got a hanky, take your hands out of your pockets. Now, our next page, children, we'll go to the third stanza. Pull your socks up, stand up straight, say thank you, don't interrupt, no one thinks you are funny, take your elbows off the table, can't you make your own mind up about anything? Now, I think you might have understood, children, we come across the parents or your elders, even your teachers also, repeatedly telling you to do the things continuously. Okay, so at that time we get irritated. We don't like someone saying repeatedly, saying the same thing, do this, don't do this, don't do this. Okay, so here You have in this first stanza, second stanza, and also the third stanza, three stanzas are said by the grown-ups. They are spoken by the grown-ups. They are telling to the child. And this poem, every poem children have a rhyme scheme. But this poem doesn't have a rhyme scheme. And it is in free verse. So grown-ups say things like speak up. So they always tell you to speak loudly. Okay, don't speak softly, speak loudly, speak up. And don't talk with your mouth full. Mouthful means keeping rice or something in your mouth and speaking out. So what happens, children, when you keep something in your mouth and speak out? It falls, it spits. Okay, so that's why they instruct you not to talk while you have the food in your mouth. Don't stare. Stare is to look at something continuously. They'll tell, don't do that. You should not look at something continuously and saying that, see that fellow, see what he is doing it. And like that, you needn't say and you didn't point it out also. Okay, and don't point. So you should not point it out. The bad manners. And don't pick your nose. Pick your nose. Some children have the bad habit, children. I think no one in our class, they have this sort of thing. So don't pick your nose means don't put the finger in your nose. Okay, it is really very, very bad. So all these things are said by the grown-ups repeatedly. They'll tell you, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. So they train you from the beginning. They'll tell you all the things. Now we'll go to the next stanza. Sit up. Say please. Sit up means sit. You have to sit straight. Okay. Say please. Less noise. You should not make noise. Shut the door behind you. Okay. So when you enter the room, you need to close the door behind you. And don't drag your feet. Drag your feet means, I think you all know it, children. While walking, you have to walk properly. You should not drag your feet like this. Okay, you should not drag it. So that is really very bad habit. You should never drag your feet. So all these things, they train you. Okay. Haven't you got a hanky? So hanky is the handkerchief. They'll tell you, they'll ask you that, haven't you have a handkerchief? So why do you require handkerchief, children? If you sneeze or anything, to clean it. Okay, for that sake you need a hanky. Okay, take your hands off your pockets. We find some children putting their hands in their pocket and walking or talking with the elders. Really, it is very bad habit. We should not do that. Okay, so all these things, don't do it. So don't. Always they train you up. Okay, now we'll go to the next page, children, and the next stanza. Pull your socks up. Pull your socks up means you will wear your socks, you know it. So if that elastic has gone, children, then that socks falls down. So they ask you to pull it up. So why do they tell you like that? So that you look very smart. If a socks has come down, it doesn't look proper. It doesn't look nice for it. Stand up straight. Say thank you. Stand up straight means you should not stand clumsily like this. It doesn't look proper. So you need to stand straight. So why do they ask you to stand straight? So that you look very, very confident. Okay. Don't interrupt. Interrupt means not to speak in between. When two persons are talking with each other, you should not interrupt in between. So you should not interrupt a person. When two persons are talking with each other, you should never interrupt them. You should not disturb them. Okay. And no one thinks you are funny. Okay, so no one thinks that you are a funny child. So you should not draw the attention of others by saying certain funny things or by saying certain things and to attract their attention. So you should not say, no one thinks that you are funny. You should not do like that. Take your elbows off the table. So when you are sitting on the dining table, children, for having your lunch or the dinner or supper or whatever it is, we find some children putting the hands on the dining table and having like this. So that is very, very bad habit. You should not do like that. You should take off your hands. So when you put, repeatedly they'll do it. Don't put the hands on that dining table. Don't put your elbows there like that. So repeatedly they'll be telling you. So the three stanzas which we have read, it tells or the parents, they train you. They'll be going on telling you, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. But did they ever ask you, did they ever allow you to enjoy your childhood, children? Did they allow you to think what you wanted to do it? No, always they were going on instructing you. So they did not allow you to think. And the whole of your childhood has been told to you repeatedly, don't do this, don't do this, don't do that. Okay. So they did not allow you to enjoy your days, enjoy your childhood. Okay. And see the last two lines, children. Can't you make your own mind up about anything? So finally a day has come when you have to decide it. Did they ever give you a chance to take a decision? No, they did not give you a chance. All these days they were going on training you. They did not give you a chance. But now how do they expect you to take a decision on your own? Because all these days you are trained. So now they want, don't you know this also? If finally they say, how a child feels. Okay, so whenever they are training you, you should get trained as well as you need to know the things. And also apart from that, you have to enjoy your childhood, because childhood days never come, children. Okay, so follow the instructions given and at the same time enjoy your childhood. Thank you, children.